Well, my name is Mattias Wallergård. I work as a researcher at Lund University in Sweden. The simplest way to explain who I am is by stating that I'm a virtual reality nerd. I had this passion for virtual environments since I was really small, just a kid. As an adult, I managed to become a researcher in this very exciting field. Basically, what we try to achieve in Blue Health is to see if we can apply virtual reality technology for a group that I believe really, really, really need virtual reality. Sometimes we see virtual reality being pushed into areas where it's like just becoming a gimmick. But here, what we see is elderly people, for example, in elderly care centers, maybe don't get out that much, maybe don't get that many visitors. We know it can be quite difficult for some of these people to get out in nature. So what we're thinking is, if you can't bring them to nature, why not bring nature to them instead? And that's what we want to try to do in Blue Health. Basically trying to build a virtual reality system that you can bring into, for example, elderly care center, and have the people there getting all sorts of different experiences of nature. What we are driven by is really exploring interactivity and agency. That sounded very academic, but what do I mean with that? Well, basically, virtual reality is something that you do in real time. You can actually have an effect on the virtual computer-generated environment. You could pick up an object, you could splash the water, you could maybe even cut down a tree if you want to do that. What level of interactivity do you want? Is it enough to be able to walk around, pick some flowers, or maybe that gets boring after a couple of weeks? Maybe you want something more advanced. And then we have the social dimension also. You could think that closing people in a virtual reality helmet is maybe not the best idea. I mean, people are social creatures. Why shouldn't we also explore the social dimension? And that's something else we really would like to do. We need to work in very close collaboration with other people, the other partners of the project. For example, we work closely with Estonian University of Life Sciences, and they know about how to design these blue environments. We're not trying to just use our gut feeling building something. Yeah, this looks like a good nature environment. We really need to base this on good, solid research that already exists. What we're doing right now is we're in kind of a design phase. We invite a group of elderly people who are healthy enough to come to our VR lab. And basically what we do is we invite them to participate in the work we're doing. So we show them stuff, we let them test stuff, we talk with them, and then based on the data we collect in this work, we do an iteration. That means that we try to improve what we have done so far, and then we test again, and then we evaluate again, and then we test again until we have some kind of virtual nature experience that we feel, okay, now this is good enough to bring to the next stage. What I find very fascinating with the project is that we will have different approaches to the same question. And University of Exeter have a different approach than us, but it complements what we do very, very well, I think. So in Exeter, the researchers look more into what kind of response can you get from more photorealistic, so-called 360 films, that maybe doesn't have so much interaction and agency, but still, I believe you can reach a long way with that kind of technology. But the question is, are there differences between these two approaches? And in that case, how large are the differences? Because it might be that as researchers and designers, we think people need to be able to pick up a stone and throw it in the water. Of course, that's really important. But maybe it turns out that it's not important at all. It's something else in VR that triggers the kind of response we're after. And maybe 360 films is good enough for this. But then again, maybe in some situations and for some users, it's not enough. And then we would need a more interactive virtual nature experience. So contrasting these two approaches, I think, is extremely interesting and important for the project, actually.